care of the governor to lay out a plan and say, this is how we're going to do something. And then literally overnight with no warning, just change everything for no rational reason.
Thanks for joining us right now for the News at 6 tonight. I'm Mark Zinni.
Hi, everyone. I'm Erin Connolly. Frustration, anger, and disappointment. That's what some Connecticut families say they're feeling after their loved ones who have disabilities got pushed back to get vaccinated.
Tonight, Channel 3 Eyewitness News reporter Courtney Zeller is joining us live with why an advocacy group wants an investigation. Courtney.
Well, they believe this group is being discriminated against. Now, originally, people with underlying medical conditions, including those with disabilities, were really up next to get this vaccine, but that has all changed. You know, doctors have said they have a higher risk of dying from COVID. Down syndrome has never stopped 32-year-old Nicholas Glome from doing what he loves.
You know, he works, he pays taxes, he votes.
Before the pandemic, Nicholas was working part-time at a supermarket, and he owns his own business, this hot dog stand. Well, that was all put on hold because of his underlying medical conditions.
It's been very, very difficult for him because he has been home. I mean, home, doing nothing for a year.
He was up next to get the COVID-19 vaccine, but that quickly changed when Connecticut Governor Ned Lamont switched the eligibility to a person's age. Nick is now last. He can't sign up for the vaccine until early May.
This isn't reasonable, and I think it's discriminatory. I really do.
And so does Disability Rights Connecticut. The advocacy group filed a formal complaint with the U.S. Office of Civil Rights, calling on the agency to investigate.
They can't wait for this. This is a matter of life and death for them.
When asked about those with underlying health issues at a press conference today, the lieutenant governor chimed in.
That people over 55 will account for 75% of the population with comorbidities and health issues. So if we keep going as the governor has planned, we're going to take care of 75% of our population.
But that still leaves out Nick.
I'm not saying that my son should be before everybody else, but he shouldn't be behind everybody else either.
So many are calling for change. There is an online petition going around. We do have that link on our Channel 3 app. We're live with the Mobile Newsroom tonight. Courtney Zeller, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.